Good afternoon to Madam Meena Mukherjee, the principal, staff members, and the Bhutanese boy who introduced me first and this girl who introduced me later on. I'm very beholden to a college here because I was also a lecturer sometime. Between 1978 and 1980, for 2 years I was lecturing in a college in Andhra Pradesh. And we used to find that, even now of course it's true with a lot of students, if there are students in a college, there will be a lot of commotion, there will be a lot of noise. I asked the principal, are the students are there in the college or no? Okay, such a peaceful atmosphere, I didn't realize that there are so many students here. I'm very happy to be here, particularly speaking to you about this inauguration of the Students' Union. Basically, when we talk about culture, I'm very happy that out of these many countries, I have seen most of the countries. And I find no other country in the world perhaps at present this much of a diversity of culture as India. You know that in India, do you know how many languages are there in India? Written and unwritten languages, there are about more than 1,600 languages. We only know of 20 or 15 or, you know, constitutionally recognized languages that can be read and spoken by majority population. But there are so many languages. Even in the neighboring state, Karnataka, there is Kurg, there is Tulu, there is Konkani, there are so many languages that, you know, it's very difficult to know the number of languages. Well, when there are so many languages, Nehru calls it, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of this country, called this country as a perfect unity in diversity. Now, in this country, you have different languages. The North Indians don't understand South Indian languages. South Indians don't understand North Indian languages. Their food habits are different. Their dress habits are different. Their customs, their traditions are different. But we are all Indians. Similarly, when I see these many students, 37 students from 10 different countries, I feel fascinated. I feel overwhelmed with the kind of enthusiasm and excitement and inspiration with which they came here. This country is a perfect country for understanding cultural diversity. And what is cultural diversity after all, when you look at it, there is absolutely no cultural diversity as it is. All culture talks about good behavior, good attitude, use of soft-spoken language towards elders and colleagues, use of understanding aesthetic sensibilities like fine arts, like sculpture, music, dance, literature, religion, philosophy, and all religions, all cultures speak of kind of a civilization that you belong to a society, and you have a responsibility towards your society, and you have some traditions and customs that you follow in that society. And all countries, all religions, all nations speak of patriotism for that country and feeling proud of your own country. All these are common qualities in every culture. What is different is the expression of culture is different, not culture itself. Itself tells us to two things. One is, treat others as you want to be treated by others. You don't want to be treated badly by anybody. So you should treat everybody with respect, with love, with care, with affection. So this is basic norms of behavioral culture. And then you have expressions like, you know, if your dance, you know, in India itself there are umpteen number of dance forms. Even classical forms of dance are different from from Andhra to Karnataka, from Karnataka to Tamil Nadu, there is in South India major dance may be Bharatanatyam, in Odissi, Oriya it is Odissi, in North India it is Kathakali, in Kerala. And in several places you have different expression. Similarly, music is different. The North Indian music is different, Hindustani music, South Indian music is different. But the concept of what is music actually? It is pleasant to listen to something. And it's pleasing to the ear. So whether it is Bhutanese music or Chinese music or Indian music or Western music, if it makes you sleepless, it is not music. If it makes you uncomfortable and you know, maybe you know, movie music is like that nowadays. But if you understand that the arts, the culture that these students are going to present now, each country has the sensitivities. You know, what culture represents is the sensitivity and the finest qualities of human nature are represented by culture. So what I mean to say is, please, as the principal said, you may come from different countries. As I was telling her a little while ago, Pakistan and India for that matter. You may not see eye to eye here. You feel very uncomfortable with a Pakistani sometimes. But you play cricket with them. And when you go out of country, suppose you go to America and you go to a restaurant, the restaurant is run by a Pakistani, but the food is Indian food, because there is very little difference between Pakistani food and Indian food. Do you eat there or you don't eat there? You have no options. You find that you all belong to one subcontinent, and then you come to, if there is a competition of cricket match between subcontinent countries, and some Australia or England, you want Pakistan or Bangladesh to win rather than England or other countries. Because man by nature goes from concentric circles. First is your home, then your society around you, then your locality around you, then your region, then your language, then your country, then your continent. After all, now when man the other day, the NASA people have bombed the moon, for water. Now all human beings want to see whether there is water or not, irrespective of nations. Some traditional people may feel very bad that moon is bombed after all. What did moon do to you? Why should you go and bomb a planet like that? But ultimately, all human beings, the basic qualities of human beings are to respect each other, to love each other, to understand the differences. Also, one more very important thing is, we should not make fun of somebody else's culture. Now, for example, this Bhutanese boy was reciting the prayer. And the girls who sang before that, Gajananam Bhutaganadi Sevitam, it was, you hear it, you understand it, because you already know it, you feel comfortable. When the Bhutanese boy said that, you find, you know, something very unusual and start making fun. So please desist from that. The audience here is to make them feel more comfortable, make them feel more respected, make them feel that this is the place we have come to the right place. So, my dear friends, I feel very happy to inaugurate this Students' Union for expatriate students. And also, the cultural that they are going to perform today, I am sure all of you will enjoy, not only enjoy, learn something from everything. Every situation in life is a teacher. So learn something and you will cherish that this is what I have learned because of these students. Because most of you perhaps will not have an opportunity to go to these many countries, but they are here. So learn from them. One word a day, and you can teach one word a day to them. You can also learn languages. So that way, it's a very wonderful amalgamation of wonderful cultures. I'm very happy to be here. I'm proud that I'm here because I find I have never known that there, I know that Mrs. Meena Muthiah runs several educational institutions and the culture that she has is simplicity. Look at how simple, unassuming and wonderful lady she is. 1/100th of what she has, if we can acquire 1/100th of what she has, that itself is culture. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. I'm happy to be here. Wonderful day for all of you. I'm looking forward to seeing at least a few cultural this morning. Thank you.